My name is Alexander Egeberg, and I'm from Herlev Gentofte Hospital in Copenhagen, Denmark. I'm the principal investigator on this study, which we recently published in the British Journal of Dermatology, examining safety and efficacy and drug survival of biologics and biosimilars for moderate to severe plaque psoriasis. We did this study because some of the newer drugs that are being developed have only shown efficacy and safety in clinical trials, but we're really lacking data from real-life clinical practice. So what we did was we examined the entire Danish population who were treated with these biologics over the past 10 years. So we both examined the traditional biologics, the TNFs, and the newer such as ustekinumab and secukinumab. We also looked at switching between the originator and the biosimilar and whether or not that affected the drug survival. Overall, regarding safety aspects, we found that patients with secukinumab had the highest incidence of adverse events. These were predominantly infections, as also seen in the clinical trials. Regarding drug survival, we saw that, as in previous studies, ustekinumab had a quite high drug survival. And quite surprisingly, secukinumab actually had the lowest drug survival of all the drugs that we investigated. Regarding the efficacy, when looking at the absolute PASI scores, so a PASI less than 5, 2 or 1, the highest results were seen for ustekinumab and adalimumab, whereas a lower result was seen for secukinumab, sort of comparing to etanercept. Switching from an originator to a biosimilar did not appear to affect drug survival, and we did not see any safety signals in this regard either. So what this means for clinicians is that there appears to be no real concern of switching between originator and biosimilar drugs. These newer drugs, such as the IL-17 inhibitors, are quite new to the market. So of course, we also need replication in other cohorts and we need longer follow-up. But from what we could see, even in the bio-naive patients, a lot of patients tend to drop out after 1 to 2 years due to lack of efficacy.